Hey, I'm Joe. He's Gregg. Gregg and Joe TV, presented by Iron Mag Labs on the MuscleSport TV network. I love Iron Mag Labs.
I love Iron Mag Labs, too.
Robert, you're the fucking best. I love you.
Dude, I'll love you even more when I get some free samples.
Don't worry. I'll give you some.
I'm just kidding.
I have some. Hey, but look at this. We have some back issues here. You can order these back issues. I pay for the shipping. MuscleSportMag.com/store. Subscriptions are $32 a year. Free shipping to the U.S. Greg, we got a...
Paper-smelling fetish, sorry.
Paper-smell. I like to smell girls' feet. This guy likes to smell paper.
Dude, I can't. I could never fucking look at a magazine, book, or anything with paper. Remember when you were a kid, you with the
mimeographs. Yeah, the mimeographs.
I can't help it. It's just
the blue ink.
It's the guinea nose.
Well,
the fucking guinea.
I can certainly relate to that. But hey, we got not one, not two, but three fucking guests on this program today.
Oh my God.
Who do we got on this program today, Gregg? Who's here? Live in the studio.
We have
Wayne DeMilia. Wow.
Now, for some of you guys who don't know who he is, bro, he's the one who started, you know, all this pro circuit of bodybuilding, IFBB. He's the one who started it. And we don't bash the IFBB here, guys. We're IFBB. We're bodybuilding. We love all bodybuilding. So there's no bashing that. So if you're looking for that, you came to the wrong place.
Well, peace and love. We're like the hippies.
Peace and love.
The San Francisco hippies with flowers in the fucking...
Bro, and even though we're still wearing the same shirts as the last two, three issues, that doesn't mean we're filming...
You're getting loopy.
Well, you know, let me smell again. But no, that doesn't mean that, you know, that we did it all...
We only have a shirt, one
same day.
Why is only one pair of pants can fit in my drawer, Alice? Right. I fucked up the honeymooners line, but you get the picture. Hey, but also, besides Wayne DeMilia coming in live in studio, we have our buddy and Muscle Sport Mag columnist, Jerry Ward, joining us on Skype.
Jerry Ward's one of my... Jerry Ward is one of my boys. Outside of bodybuilding, you know, we've been to dinner together. We're friends outside of bodybuilding, but he's a great guy. You got to hear what he's got to say.
Good shit coming up with Jerry. Always. And last but not least...
Come on,
five-time world champion.
I fucking...
Boxing champion.
Dude, our boy. It's
Vinny
our boy.
Vinny Paz, formerly Vinny Pazienza.
Joe hates when I do that.
Bleed for This, the motion picture starring Miles Teller, playing Vinny Paz, a true story. Vinny Paz's comeback after he had a broken neck, was in a halo, practically paralyzed. Doctor said, don't you dare fight, let alone, you know, don't you do anything, let alone fight. They wrote him off. He was never going to do anything
again. Do you know what saved his life? You know what saved, honestly?
Steroids?
Iron Mag Labs. Dude, Bob, Robert, whatever your name is, DiMaggio. Iron Mag Labs, baby. Iron Mag, okay? Samples, free samples. Anyway, no, just kidding. I'm just kidding, guys. Listen, Vinny Paz is our boy, the Paz man. He's coming here to kick our ass. Oh, shit.
He can.
Dude, I'm leaving.
I wouldn't fuck with him. We'll be right back.
After these moments, hey, stop fucking around.
Gregg, Goliath Labs has been a sponsor of Muscle Sport Magazine since 2008. Basically, since the site first came on board. I want to talk about their products here. Isolate protein, 24 grams of protein in this scoop. Unbelievable. Monster Shred pre-workout, Deep Cell Matrix, NO2, NO Monster, Stimuloid, Extreme Sex Stimulant.
Wait, Stimuloid. Okay, let's talk about some of these first. Is that Stimuloid? What the fuck's that? That's Ejaculoid.
Ejaculoid. My personal favorite, actually. Bart is knows. I've loved it for years.
Is this the blue capsules?
Yes.
That's the one. I gotta tell you something. It works really, really good. But it works almost too good.
It works. Well, you know what?
Kind of fucked me up, man.
Take only one. You don't need to take one.
That means it works.
Oh, it works fucking amazing. Tribuloid, Test Booster, Growloid, Humaloid, Herbrex, Sex Enhancer. For men and women, get this for the misses, a perfect stocking stuffer. Go to goliathlabs.com right now.
Mm-hmm. What's up, guys? It's Boston Lloyd, and you're watching Muscle Sport TV.
And welcome back to Muscle Sport TV's Gregg and Joe TV, presented by Iron Mag Labs, being joined live in the studio by one Wayne DeMilia.
The legend. This guy's a legend. I remember going to the Night of the Champions, and I missed the very first one, which I think was 78, because I went in 79.
78, yeah.
Right, but I remember seeing Robbie Robinson battling it out, and Danny Padilla, and that, boy, let me tell you, those Night of the Champions were amazing, and were a treat for a young, you know, I was a young bodybuilder back then, but oh my God, you know?
Now, you were a promoter. What was your exact title?
I was the promoter at a contest, but in 1979, I was made the head of the pro division. IFBB. When Arnold went off to make movies, I got the position. Before that, I was just a member of the pro committee. I went to Joe Weider in 1975. I went out to California, drove around for 3 hours to find Woodland Hills, and then drive around another hour to find Irwin Street. And I had no appointment, and I wanted to go see him. And so they made me wait till about 5:30, and finally he goes, what are you here to see me about? You know, that way Joe would talk. So I tell him, there should be, you know, a lot of pro shows like golf and tennis.
Right.
You know, in Grand Prix events, and they get points to go into the Olympia and this and that. And he goes, it'll never work, only the Olympia. Of course, 3-4 months later, there was a editorial by Joe saying, there should be Grand Prix events.
He had a brainstorm.
But he also had said to me, you got to talk to my brother.
Right.
He's the head. And I'm going, wow, there's two of you? I didn't know there was two. I don't know.
Right.
So I eventually got up to Montreal in 76. They had the universe up there in the Congress, and visiting Ben back in those days was like visiting the Pope. You had to contact them ahead of time, and they gave you your time. And I was given, I remember, 10 minutes from 2 to 2:10 on the Thursday afternoon. So I go in, and he's standing, you know, he's in a suite, and there were steps going up, and he's sitting in a armchair, and you sit three steps down in a regular chair.
Like in court.
Yeah. And you're looking up at him, and he goes, you've been writing to me. How can I help you? And I give him my whole spiel that I want to run pro shows and create pro bodybuilding and this and that. And he looks at me and he goes, do you compete? I go, no. He goes, do you own a gym? I said, no, I work for AT&T.
Oh, shit.
He goes, do you even work out? I said, Mr. Weider, you're skinnier than I am, and you're running this thing.
Right.
Don't knock me. I said, yeah.
Holy shit.
You know. So he laughed, and he goes, well, there's going to be a pro committee started tonight. And if the chairman wants to put you on the committee, he'll put you on the committee. I said, okay, who's the chairman? He goes, our greatest champion, Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Really?
I said, okay. He goes, you know him? I said, yeah, I'm friends with George Butler. I'm like an unpaid consultant on that film that they're doing.
Right.
Which pumping was pumping iron.
I didn't know that. That's a great little tidbit there.
And so I said, I'll find Arnold and Nuitis. No lie. I leave at 2:10, because then my time was up.
Yeah.
I go to the elevator. I push the button to go up to my room. Elevator door opens up, and there's one guy in the elevator.
Arnold.
Wow.
Now, I knew Arnold, like I said, because when the film ran out of money, they would have screenings.
Right.
And invite George Butler and Charles Gaines' family's rich friends to come to donate.
Kind of like Kickstarter today. Yeah. GoFundMe.
Early part of GoFundMe.
Precursor.
And they would sometimes bring Arnold in and, you know, introduce him and then show uncut scenes of the film. So that's how I got to know Arnold real good. And then he'd come Mid-City Gym. He trained in Mid-City. He'd come at lunchtime. That's where I would train every day.
Right.
And so on and so forth. So that's how I knew him. So I get in the elevator. I said, Arnold, you're starting a pro committee tonight. He goes, yeah. I said, I want to be on it. He said, okay, be in my room 7 o'clock. Here's my room number.
Oh, shit.
And at that first meeting was Jim Lorimer.
Right.
Boyer Coe. John Balick. Paul Graham.
Okay.
A guy by the name of Warren Langman.
I knew Paul Graham. I knew every one of those guys except Warren Langman.
And it was said, well, only the guys in this room can run a pro show.
Really?
You know, we were the so-called beginning promoters. Now, this was November 1976. And so I had my date on hold. And I remember when I got back from the meeting, I called Charlie Blake, because I had met Charlie in the gym. And I said to him, we got the rights. When I get back Monday, I'm going to go put the deposit down on the thing. We got a year and a half to promote this. I said, you know, we got to sit down, make a deal, me and you.
Right.
And the way I met Charlie Blake was, I had promoted one amateur show back in 1975, the AABA. You remember those?
Right. I remember those.
Yeah, AABA, Mr. Eastern America.
Yep.
And I drove everyone crazy in Mid-City Gym to buy a ticket. I mean, I would just walk through the gym. You got your ticket yet? You got your ticket yet? People buy tickets just, Wayne, get away from me. Here's your $5, you know, wow. $5, $6.50.
$5 yeah. Now today. So wait, hold that thought right there. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back to wrap this story up and hear what Wayne is doing today. Yeah, he's still doing this bodybuilding thing.
This is incredible stuff.
Hey, Robert, it's Jay Cutler, four-time Mr. Olympia here. I want to send a big thank you to yourself and your company, Pumped Up Fitness Nutrition, for the support of Cutler Nutrition.
What's up, everyone? This is Rich Piano. I just want to let you guys know you can get all my supplements at Pumped Up Fitness Nutrition.
At Pumped Up Fitness Nutrition.
Pumped Up Fitness Nutrition. I will see you there.
God damn it.
Pumped Up Fitness Nutrition. The Hulk will be you.
Store's freaking awesome, man. Pumped Up Fitness and Nutrition.
God damn it.
Come here, get all your 5% needs. You know, everything's fully in stock at all times here. It's 100% in stock. This store is fucking awesome.
I look forward to seeing you guys soon.
Where else?
Where else?
You might be asking yourself, what the fuck are these guys wearing? Gregg and I are wearing the oversized rag sleeve workout top from tmichael.com. M-I-C-H-E-A-L, not the common spelling, so make sure you log in correctly because you won't get their site if you go in there. They got their Powerhouse Gym, Automix, World Gym, NPC, Zubaz, Chic. They got all the brands you want. Performance, footwear, gorilla wear, 3X, up to 3X with their big tops. Tees, tank tops, sweatshirts, hoodies, everything. TMichael.com.
Hi, it's Rick Drayson, and you're watching Gregg and Joe on MuscleSport TV.
Welcome back, Gregg and Joe TV. So, Wayne, you started to promote these shows now.
Right. I was saying the first show I ever did was the AABA, Mr. Eastern America, and I nagged everybody in the gym to buy a ticket. I sold it out. I made money.
The Night of Champions was the second most prestigious show, rivaling the Olympia.
It was my favorite show, to be honest.
A huge show in the IFBB calendar.
Look, I lived in, you know, we live in New York, you know what I mean? Yeah. So we're big, you know, obviously United Champions, but the way you put it on, I mean, you had such an incredible, I mean, I can't tell you, guys who went on to win the Night of Champions from, you know, from guys like Samir Banu, did Chris Dickerson win the Night of Champions?
Dorian.
He was skinny. He was like really gaunt face. Yeah. I was there. I never missed one. Only till recently have I missed them. But I was at every night. I never missed the Night of Champions. The only Night of Champions I ever missed was the very first one because I was young. I was just finishing high school. I didn't know. But in 79, from 79 straight on till the last one, I was at every one. And you could not get better than those shows. Those shows were just the rivalries, the stage, everything was so exciting.
What are you doing nowadays? Your health is better,
is good.
That's the most important thing.
And after taking some time off, and then I did that one unsanctioned show because all the pros wanted me to do it, and then the only one that showed up to compete was Lee Priest.
Lee Priest is one of ours. He's with us, yeah, by the way.
And then I helped organize the bowl game in Washington, D.C. And then I got contacted by Major League Baseball. And I was an independent consultant for Major League Baseball for a year. They took me to spring training. They brought me to games.
Now
I was in heaven.
I just caught wood. You know how much I love baseball.
That's a cool
you and
game.
I talk. Yeah. We talk about baseball outside this stuff here because we're Yankee fans.
I did that.
Met fan.
And then I got a call from someone I had met years before, and he says, "You know people that could raise money." I said, yeah, I do. He goes, can you raise money for my film studio? He says, I need to refurbish it. I said, okay, let me see what I can do. So I got some people interested, but I couldn't get the money because he had no revenue coming in.
Right.
So he goes to me, he goes, why don't you buy the studio? Wow, who can buy a film studio?
That's not you ain't kidding.
Yeah, I said, all right, let me see if I could put something together. So I found a person that does creative foreign funding, which I got great terms. We're right at the brink of signing. The film studio has six buildings. It's on about 75 acres of land in North Carolina. There's 250 acres of empty land around it, so I could buy more land. So I want to produce my own television shows and movies and rent it out on one side. And on the other side, I'm going to do music festivals outdoor.
Really?
It's in the middle of no place, and we could put it in there. Private jet port, half a mile away. We can helicopter the people. And
my mind like
was,
that.
You know, I was more into the entertainment part of bodybuilding than the hardcore part.
Yeah. But I felt...
You know, you love Night of Champions because we love ran it. It was 2 hours and 10 minutes, fast moving, no lulls, entertainment things in it. It was always something.
Oh, very entertaining.
And everybody, when they left, they said, "Oh man, you should run two or three of these a year."
Guys went on to win the Olympia too. Yeah. So let's be honest with that. They all went on to win the Mr. Olympia. All
so
the guys who won.
When this opportunity came across, I'm saying, "Wow, yeah, I could." I got all these ideas for TV shows. I got ideas for movies. That's open doors for me. So once I take over and refurbish it, I mean, that's where my head is really at. Yeah, I've been hired as a consultant on the Mr. America.
Okay.
And the Mr. America is going to be held in Baltimore October 6th to 8th. But it's a team.
Right.
The reason why I agreed to become a consultant is lawyers. There's accountants. There's marketing people. There's advertising people, there's PR firms, there's all sorts of people involved in this event. It's going to be aligned with a major charity. I can't say what that charity is right now until the contracts are signed, but
right.
It's a major charity with a major sports celebrity.
Is it drug tested? Somebody told me it's going to be drug tested.
Yes, it's drug tested.
Okay.
That's why these doors are being opened. They're in negotiations now with a major sportswear company that we all know. And we might even be wearing it, you know, interested in doing a Mr. America sportswear line besides sponsoring you.
Wow. Smart.
We're looking at major companies. Major companies. You know, yeah, there'll be bodybuilding companies there, but we're looking at major companies. And the marketing people are saying they will get television.
Okay. Now, dude, the title alone is spaghetti.
The title is the best title. The title was bought by a wonderful guy by the name of Bruce Abel. He lives in Maryland. He owns about 14, 16 Gold's Gyms.
Nice.
They ran it twice. It wasn't run well.
Okay.
They hired me back in May to come see the event. It was running a Six Flag Great Adventure amusement park on 4th of July weekend. It was quite warm. I'll just say that. When the show was over, his wife came to me and said, "What did you think?" I said, "Well, you're paying me to be the truth, tell you the truth. It was one of the worst shows I've ever been at." And she goes, "Will you run it for us next year and be a consultant and tell everybody what to do? We don't know what to do. We got people, but they're not bodybuilding people. They don't know what to do."
Do you have a location for it?
Yes, it's the Baltimore Convention Center Baltimore, Maryland. So there's going to be a three-day expo with it. There's going to be celebrity appearances. It's right by the Inner Harbor. And I hope both of you will be down there.
Oh, dude, I'll go, definitely.
Right?
Definitely.
Muscle Sports, we'll have a booth there.
Dude.
And maybe you can do some
interviews.
I'll be checking out the girls. Yeah. I mean, I've seen some of the...
We got to go to break, though. I want to thank Wayne for joining us.
Wayne's my boy.
It's great seeing you, and I'm glad that you're doing
it. A fellow New York City Italian right here.
There you go.
Greg, GBDTClothing.com. Look at these fucking shirts, guys. Our buddy Damian Martin at Get Big or Die Trying
my boy.
Hooked us up with some great apparel. They're the manufacturers of
quality hardcore gym wear. Men's medium through 3XL. I don't know about you, but you might be 3XL. I'm certainly
not. Nah, dude,
I used to be. This is a 2XL, actually. Ladies got small, medium, large. There's t-shirts, tanks, sleeveless hoodies.
I like it.
It's pretty cool. You got two-sided apparel. There's two sides to all of these shirts.
Right.
Make sure you say hi to our buddy Damien at gbdtclothing.com.
This is Angel Savagno, and you're watching Gregg and Joe on MuscleSport TV.
Hey, Gregg, our buddy Bill Toko over at War Room Nutrition. He's now a sponsored athlete for the War meal Room prep Nutrition. Company, FitFoodsRx.com. They're owned by IFBB pro Ken Jackson. They're the biggest selection of healthy cuisine, portion-controlled, and customized signature meals down to the ounce. I can't go wrong, bro.
Can't go wrong.
Pick up or FedEx delivery. Make sure you use this discount code when you order War Room for Bill's code at FitFoodsRx.com. Stop eating all of that other shit and stop cooking. You know this is much
better. Stop being cheap. Buy the fucking food.
This is Jason Genova. You're watching Muscle Sports TV.
And we are being joined right now via Skype by Jerry Ward, MSM columnist, Bios 3 Training, the diet guy, they like to call him. You're more than the diet guy, bro. You're the everything guy, in my opinion, Jerry.
Well, the diet guy's how it gets started, you know, so.
No, but he definitely is the everything guy, because let me tell you something. That's how I met Jerry. I couldn't believe just he talks about things that are even.
We met in 2011. That's where we met.
You're right. I do. Yes, we did meet. But what I'm saying is, what really got me was when I started seeing like all the cool shit you talk about that pertains to life. And I think that you've helped a lot of people in, you know, with their life, not just with their diet and bodybuilding. Because there's more to body. We're all human. You know what I'm saying? And we all have the same problems. And you know, you were telling us. You know, that you were once a heroin addict and how you know, and I think that that right there,
yeah,
a lot of people can in this sport fuck around with drugs like that. And, you know, what do you have to say about that? Because I'm sure you've gotten a lot of feedback like, Jerry, you've changed my life and, you know, talking to you about these things.
Yeah, I get things like, you know, people will come up to me at the expos and stuff and talk about that stuff more than the bodybuilding stuff, to be honest with you. You know, I had one guy, I'll never forget it. He walked up to me, I think it was at the LA last year, to be honest with you. And he walks up and he kind of leans forward into me and he says, and his wife's behind him, he says, she doesn't know. He said, but I battled addiction for years and years and years. Oh, he goes, shit. And I thought I was completely alone, you know, and he starts crying and like he's trying to keep it from his wife, like right behind him. And I'm like, here I am, like, you know, his wife who, you know, with his wife and kid are back there and he's bearing this secret to me that she doesn't even know. You know, I'm sitting there going like, that's kind of like a powerful thing where people just want to open up to you like that. But as soon as I started talking about it, emails started coming, you know, and even this morning around here in D.C., there's a DJ who was talking about these safe zones that they're trying everything they can right now to curtail people from overdosing on all the stuff that's out there. And it's like a safe zone where you can go and shoot up and they have medical trained people there in case you overdose. They keep you alive. Wow. So, I mean, I think it's so widespread now. And it all started from like the pain pills, I think, for most people. You know, one guy said he broke his back, and next thing you know, he's off and running a heroin habit like a year later. So it's not, you know, and the bodybuilders, they started fucking with Nubane back in the day, and the Nubane led to Oxycontin when you couldn't get the Nubane, and then it led to heroin. Like, it was like an epidemic back then, and I don't know what it's like now, to be honest with you. I don't know many guys that fuck with that shit now. But pain pills, I mean, those are still something that people always, oh, can you get pain pills? Can you get pain pills? Like, you know, they always ask for them. And I'm like, you know, what do you need them for? Are you fucking injured? Like, no, I like to take them when I go out and stuff. I'm like, that's how it starts.
Oh, man.
You know, you take a few and go out, have a few beers, and next thing you know, you got no money left, your girl left you. You know, I mean, you're fucking, it's a mess, you know?
And you're so addicted, it's not even funny. Because, you know, my ex-girlfriend died. She was a heroin addict. And then she went from heroin to Oxycontins and all that stuff. And eventually, that killed her.
Yeah, it's hard to, I've had a few friends that died from it that, well, you know, Oxycontin and heroin are two different things. Even with opiates, it's hard to figure out if you're taking this much Oxycontin, how much heroin should you take? So try to figure out the dosage is not, you know, they just keep taking more until they hit their limit and they just wind up overdosing.
You're right. And but that's where I think, like, you know, your whole approach to everything is so different because you talk about a lot of life things on your channel. And to me, you're one of the only channels I watch. I even comment after a lot of your videos, especially the heavy stuff, you know. And I feel that That's more important than anything. And I love the fact that you share your life with people. And it made me a fan of you. And that's why I got to be honest with you.
I mean, I think that, you know, the age that you and I are and Joe, and as we get older, we think that, you know, when we're younger, we don't think anything about that shit. You know, the 22-year-olds, they don't think about any of the stuff that I talk about.
No way.
When you hit 35, 40, 45, you start thinking about all those things, life things, like my father just passing away. I mean, I knew people that had parents that passed away, but I never knew what that felt like.
Right.
You know what I mean? So it's like as you're older, you experience more stuff. And, you know, some of the stuff does get through to the younger guys. And I think that's where it's really important. I think that, you know, telling the guys now that have gone through it or are going through it, that's important. But getting those younger guys, so when they kind of encounter that, they go, oh, man, I remember Jerry talking about this shit. Or maybe they don't even remember it's me. They just remember they heard about a situation where, you know, a new vein led to this or Oxycontin or whatever. And it just might make them think twice and go, maybe I don't want to go down that road, you know?
You're right. You know what, Jerry? I think that young guys today or even with the steroids, they think they can do whatever the fuck they want. It's unlimited. You know, what is it? Yeah, does it make you, you know, bigger? Yeah, give it to me. It doesn't matter. And I think that that's, as you get older, you start realizing shit, you know? And, you know, I think that that's where your channel, to me, you have so much more to offer than just a, yeah, let's get jacked, you know? Oh, you know, ketogenic diet, you know? It's more. And that's why I can watch your channel every day, you know what I'm saying? I love your stuff. You know that, you know, because I've told you, and I've commented, you know?
Yeah, you know, nowadays, reality TV is, like, a big thing, and, you know, people want to see into other people's lives. And I find it interesting when I hear about, you know, Jay Cutler going to buy a new dog. You know what I mean? The most random shit. Like, I don't care if he's bench pressing. You know, let me see that. He went to get his hair cut a different way or whatever. Right. You know? And, like, that seeing it to other people's lives, I think, is, like, you know, it's not that you're looking for just entertainment value. You're looking to kind of connect to somebody and, you know, realize that you guys are kind of similar. You know, so it's like they're looking for not to belong to something. I guess to belong to something, but realize that they're not weird for thinking, you know, I should go get a new dog. Jay Cutler did it. You know what I mean? Like, it's kind of like bonding people together and kind of giving them a different understanding of things, but showing them like what's really going on in your life, and then go, oh, I can relate to that because I'm going through it in mine.
Because you're human first. Yeah, you're human before you're a bodybuilder. Nobody understands it. When you're a young kid bodybuilding, yeah, man, that's all they give a shit about, you know? But they don't realize that, you know, it's not easy to making a living out of it. Trust me, I know. I've been doing this shit fucking since the 70s. And you know, it there's more to bodybuilding than just, you know, working out in the gym. You're still a human first, and that's the part that a lot of these guys don't cultivate that life. You know what I mean? The normal life, you know? And, you know, so, anyway, I give you kudos, man. You're my favorite YouTuber. And my friend. You're my friend. Outside the YouTube shit.
Yeah. Hey, Jerry, we got to go in a quick, in a little bit, so I want to give you a chance to get some plugs out there, man. Go right ahead.
I've always, Primeval Labs, I cannot say enough about them. They've been, you know, super good to me. They've been better than what I thought they would be. I'm with LegendarySupplementsNow.com. It's an online company. They have a store, too, out in Arkansas, which I went to a grand opening for them, you know, last year. You know, Nutrition Solutions, who's been a huge part of me staying lean year-round for the last 2 years. They have, like, a rotating menu. So it's like every week they send you different food. Whatever you don't like, you tell them you don't like it, but it comes, you know, it's chicken marsala 1 week. Chicken palm the next week, like it's just constantly rotating. So I can't thank them, all three of those, enough for, you know, being out there and helping me and supporting me. No matter what the fuck comes out of my mouth, they're not mad at it. You know what I mean? They're not telling me I should say this or I should say that or this image. They don't give a fuck, and you gotta appreciate that. You know, as always, the BioS3 channel. I actually have a ebook coming out, Greg. You might be interested in this because you went to Mexico once, but I don't know. So the ebook is actually 2017 Mexican Anabolics. When I was down there, I went to all these pharmacies. I tracked the pharmacies, what was in them, found what was available, the new companies that are down there, and even made a shopping list for people that want to go down there. They can print it out of the ebook.
I love it.
Take it down there, go right to the pharmacy and say, I need this, 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 and this. The price, everything's on it. So that'll be coming out soon because nobody does those Dan Duchesne things anymore. I used to love those books. And Bill Phillips and Llewellyn and those guys. I was like, nobody's doing it anymore. I'm going to be down there anyways. Let me take a couple days and just, you know, do everything while I'm down here and put it all in the ebook. So that'll be coming out soon, too.
Cool. Wow. I just got wood hearing that shit.
You might have to go to the fucking...
I just got wood.
Orbits.com, me and you soon. Book a fucking flight. Jerry, thanks so much for joining us today on Gregg and Joe TV, MuscleSport TV Network.
And we're being joined right now on the phone, Gregg, by Vinny Paz, formerly...
The
Pazienza, the Pazmanian Devil.
I love him. Dude, that guy's my favorite fighter.
5-time world champion, and also Bleed for This, the new movie about his whole life and his comeback, which is just fucking amazing, Vinny. What's going on, bro?
It's good to talk to you guys. I'm glad you got in touch with the Tasmanian Devil, finally.
Yeah, well, we saw you about, was it like 2 years ago we met on Johnny P's show, and I'm glad we did. So this is pretty cool to get you on our program.
5-time world champion.
Glad to be here. Glad to be here. Isn't it crazy how time flies? I say it every day.
Yeah.
Time flies. Unbelievable. That was 2 years ago.
Yeah.
I feel like we just saw you, man. But I'll tell you what, you're a great guy. I like your not just your intensity in the ring, but even outside. You're a good man. I feel like you give off a good aura. I remember hanging out with you, man, and it was just, you're a good man. I like that. I got a good feeling from you.
Very nice.
Hey, Vinny, so the movie has gotten fucking great reviews. People love it. Tell us a little bit about it. I know it was a long time in the making, but give us a little quick synopsis of how it's been since the movie has come out for you.
Well, the movie's absolutely fabulous. I was really proud of the guys that played the part. Aaron Eckhart was awesome, and nobody could have played me better than Miles Teller.
Mm-hmm.
He did a great job, and everything was good. You know, there's some things that you have to deal with in life, which everybody does, and I'm not even talking about my broken neck. I'm talking about on the other side of the fence with these guys who put this great movie together for me. I just, like, radio rat bastards that, you know, I just can't even believe some of the things that they've done. But, you know, in the long run, the main thing for me, the best thing is that the movie is absolutely fabulous, and I'm very proud of it. And that's it. The rest will take care of itself.
Yeah, definitely. Hey, you should be proud of it, Vinny. I mean, this is your life story. Your doctors told you you'd never, like, do anything again, let alone fight. And you went back and won multiple belts. I mean, it's almost, it's like if we didn't know it was a true story, we'd think it was a great fucking Hollywood story, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. That's a great compliment.
No problem.
That might have been the best compliment. That might have been the best compliment I've ever gotten in the last month or so.
Okay, I'll take it. Hey, I also got to tell you.
Great. I'm already playing. That's what I want
to say. Thank you, bro. I'll tell you, though, Vinny, I read the feature article in Sports Illustrated about you in the movie that came out probably about a month ago. And Vinny, as a journalist, I read that article, and it really was very powerful. And I read this one quote from you that I said, I knew as soon as I heard it, I said, that's Vinny. You were talking to Miles, and he was saying, how did you bench? No, he was bench pressing with the halo on. And he was filming in it, and he was having trouble doing it. And you said, hey, twat cakes, that thing was screwed into my skull. And I was like,
I did say that to him.
That line was in the Sports Illustrated article, bro. And I was reading the article, and I was laughing my ass off. And I was like, that is Vinny to a T. So, great fucking line, bro. I wish that should have been in the movie.
that's nice of you to say. And you know what's funny? Like, the swear to God crosses up to heaven. Last night, I read that Sports Illustrated piece because I saw it in my house. And I glanced through it when it first came out because there was so much media going around.
Yeah.
I was getting sick of myself, you know? So last night I sat down and I read it and I was like, wow, what a great story.
Yeah.
What a really, really good story they put in. And that was the one, it's the Sports Illustrated issue where The Rock was on the cover.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's right. Yeah. Okay. They took that shot with a smartphone, believe it or not. It was an ad for a smartphone, and they shot the cover of The Rock using like a Galaxy or some shit like that, which... Just a little anecdote. As in publishing world, I look at these things and I go, oh, shit.
And so life's so crazy.
Yeah.
You know, speaking of life being crazy, Vinny, it's the last time we saw you, you were telling us that they were about to do a movie on you. This is when we,
right,
you know, so
yeah.
Like when we saw you, it was just like, holy shit, you know, like they're going to do a movie on me and all that. And now here we are talking about the movie that's out, you know.
How great it is, yeah.
Yeah, And how nuts is it that we got Martin Scorsese to be one of the producers? That's humongous.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man, forget about it. I mean, that's a home run.
That's fucking beautiful, bro.
He's such an icon. You know, I'm so glad to get a picture with him. You know, and I hugged him. I said, oh, Martin, it's so nice to meet you. He says, I love you, man. He made my week.
Yeah, well, that's fucking, you're two legends there. You in the ring and Scorsese being, you know, Hollywood amazing director, especially as an Italian. I mean,
Italian boys rule.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, Vinny, we got to let you go in about, 30 seconds. We got another interview lined up, but I want to give you a chance to plug whatever you want to plug. You want to plug the wine, you want to plug your site, everything you want. Go ahead, bro.
How about you just check me out on Vinny Paz 5 Time on Twitter, and I got VinnyPaz.com. It's going to be a good site in the very, very near future, and a lot of things will be happening off of it and because of it, and everything's cool, man. Life's crazy. Got to stay strong at all times.
Yeah.
That a boy, Vinny.
You're a hero, bro.
That a boy.
You have a great story, and that's what made a great fucking movie. Vinny Paz, 5-time world champion.
Love you too, bro. You're still kicking ass, man. You're still kicking ass.
We'll talk to you soon, Vinny. Hey, you know you got a good fucking product when they call it the Champions Club, Gregg, right?
Oh, yes, you do.
Steroid-club.com.
You had me at steroids.
Your privacy is very important. They have everything you want there, pretty much.
Everything?
They even got fat burners, anti-estrogens, sex pills, liver cleansing, painkillers, injectables, pills, peptides, all that good shit. Packages available from beginner to advanced cycles. And mass and cut cycles also. They have, you know, nice little kits together. Make sure you go to steroid-club.com.
Been there, sold that.
International Protein, Australia's leading supplement company, leading the way for over a decade. Now, the all-new performance range. Leading the way is International Protein's Superior Whey. Superior Whey's gut-friendly formulation is perfect for athletes at any training level. Do you train hard and work hard? Protein Synergy 5 ensures a steady supply of muscle-building protein for up to 7 hours. Looking to burn fat and maintain muscle? IsoCut's active levels of green tea, natural caffeine and hydroxycitric acid ensures IsoCut's will be your new partner in your weight management goals. Want to get to the next level? International Protein's amino-charged WPI will get you there. Intense aerobic or heavy anaerobic training requires a fast recovery. International Protein's Amino Recovery is developed to help achieve the fastest recovery possible. International Protein's all-new performance range, trusted by Australia's elite athletes to deliver the best tasting food for growth.
This is Jerry Ward from Violence Retraining at Primeval Labs, and this is the Gregg and Joe MuscleSport TV show Bicep, and we're out.
We'd like to thank our guests for coming down here, especially Wayne DeMilia. Did a nice long ride.
Awesome.
Doesn't live around the corner.
Awesome guy.
Thank you so much for coming down, and also for Jerry Ward to join us on Skype, and Vinny Paz. Pazzy. I still have to say Paz. I know his name is legally Vinny Paz.
Vinny Paz.
I still call him Pazmanian Devil.
You don't like that.
I still call him Pazienza. But thank you for Vinny for joining us on a audio call, and Gregg is playing with the Iron Mag Labs again. Of course, we want to thank Iron Mag Labs, title sponsor for the Gregg and Joe TV show on the Muscle Sport TV network. Make sure you like us on YouTube, like Gregg Valentino's channel, and go to MuscleSportMag.com. We'll see you next time.